another, can we? 62.9, lap after lap after lap. He's edging ever closer to a place in the history books. He's only run twice this year, Sonia, and on both occasions he's broken a world record. World 5K on the road back in February in Monaco, then the 5,000 metres on the track in August. If he does this, though, there's such a mystique, there's such a majesty about the 10,000 metres, 25 soul-destroying laps of a track. I think this would beat the other two. I think this would be the key run of the year, and I'd actually rank this alongside winning the 10,000 last year in Doha. This would be some achievement.
I think it would just be another step of improvement of his greatness, and it's hard to even hear what's going on here now with three laps to go. And this is very, very possible with 23 up. That's another 63-second lap there. I mean, he's just like knocking off these laps even after even. And I can see a sprint coming for the last lap. So I think we can start. We want to stand up and start celebrating right now. But with 1 kilometer to go, you know, this is where, you know, the concentration may turn into racing. And, you know, there's a number of athletes that he's lapping here to chase 23, 36. With 1 kilometer to go, he has 1.5 seconds under his projected time, which is well under world record pace. So this is definitely, it's been world record day in Valencia today. It's been named that. This could be a holiday after tonight.
This is so exciting. We really hope you're enjoying this. I just can't stop smiling. I can't believe what we're in the process of witnessing here. If he can keep it going. Two laps to go. And if you're watching this with a little brother or a sister, or a son or a daughter, or a niece or a nephew, get them down to your local athletics track. This is the most accessible, friendly sport in the world. If you can run or jump or throw, you can be a world-class athlete. There is no barrier where our sport is concerned. And these are the kind of images that inspire the next generation of global stars, not only perhaps in Uganda or across Africa, but around the world. He is standing as a symbol of all that is great. He's pouring his heart and soul into this record attempt, into this journey to greatness that he is relentlessly pursuing with painful session after painful session. And he's tantalizingly close now to doing something he may not have thought was possible 6 or 7 years ago. The world junior champion, the world senior champion, has 400 meters to go. Can he do it? Can he keep it going? He's ahead of the green lights at the moment. Another 63, but 63.8. He's getting tired. But he's flying the flag brilliantly for Uganda. He comes from the Sabini tribe, who traditionally have a low standing in Ugandan culture, but he's rewriting what's possible in his country. He's a shining example of all that is possible with determination. He's a slight man, but he's big in personality, big in talent, and big in ambition. This has been absolutely incredible here. Coming round, he's just got to keep driving. Kenenisa Bekele's time, 26.17. We've seen one world record. I think we might be about to see another. This has been absolutely fantastic. The hairs on the back of my neck are standing to attention. It's a standing ovation from everyone here. He has roared with the heart of an African lion. He's delivered. It's a world record for Joshua Cheptegei, the Commonwealth champion. The world champion is the fastest man in history, over 6.25 miles. And this is a night that will never be forgotten by any of us who were privileged enough to be here. He has shone like a star in the night sky of Spain. That was incredible.